Hi and welcome back to another Ready to Ride session. You will have noticed the obvious piece of equipment on the floor this time, and this is two half foam rollers. Some of you may well be familiar with foam rollers, half ones or full ones. Full foam rollers are just the same as these, but they are a full cylinder. To be perfectly honest though, I actually think that very few people are capable of doing an effective workout of any kind on a full foam roller. The balance displacement that you get is really very extreme, and what people tend to do instead of using their core is massively recruit lots of other stabilising muscles, and it becomes a very ineffective and potentially injury inducing form of exercise. So unless you are really, really experienced and really competent and feel that you can safely use a full foam roller, stick to the half ones. I think all the work we do on foam rollers is fantastic for riders. The balance displacement is really second to none, and it's probably the only piece of kit that I feel, apart from maybe some of the bigger ball work, that really mimics some of the balance displacement you get when you're riding. I'm going to do this session in two halves. First of all, lying flat on the rollers, and second of all, standing up. So you can see I've placed my two rollers end to end. Unless you are particularly tall, this should work really well. You should have enough room for your head right down through to your pelvis to fit on. If you are tall and you don't fit, get a nice fat head block and have it for your head, and then the rest of your spine should fit on nice and neatly. So I'm going to show you how to lie on this. You need to make sure you've got plenty of room for your head, you're not tipping off the end, but also plenty of room for your pelvis so that's not tipping off the end. Then find just a nice relaxed position, don't worry about anything else, just get relaxed onto the roller. And for a moment or two, just appreciate the fact that your spine is supported down its entire length, and relax into that nice supported straight position. I think just about everybody, apart from the odd person who has a scoliosis, so that's a curvature of the spine, finds this position very relaxing, so make the most of it. And then once you've done that, find that neutral pelvis position, so nice and flat, if you could have a plate balance on your tummy, and pelvic floor onto floor three. It will feel a little different because your feet are lower than your bottom, but you should still be able to find that position fairly effectively. Then take your arms up so they're pointing up to the ceiling. And this first exercise is working on shoulder blade control, and you're going to push up with your shoulder blades towards the ceiling and pull down with your shoulder blades towards the floor so that you hug your roller. So you are repeating this, pushing up through the shoulder blades, pulling down. And I think this is one of the best exercises for improving symmetry of contact and also activation of your main shoulder blade muscles in a way that you can really see that affects your contact and the movement you have of your arms as you're riding. And anyone that's read the Ready to Ride blog will be familiar with the whole strength around the shoulder girdle concept that I've talked about. And what we're looking for is a nice light hand and elbow so we can be really soft, and all the strength and the control of the movement comes from the shoulder blades, and that's what this exercise really achieves. That's a really useful one to do to get some good feedback, because you can feel the roller and you can see your hands. So then you bring your arms back down, rest your hands onto your headlights just like you would for any of the other exercises. Check you're in the neutral pelvis position, pelvic floor onto floor three. And then you can do the same sort of exercises that you would normally do lying on the mat. So you can do your hip twist, that's alternating which knee rolls out side to side, keeping your headlights level, keeping the pelvic floor onto floor three, and try not to rest down through your elbows. The temptation is to fix with the elbows. Try to keep them off the floor if at all possible. Then you can have a go at doing your scissors. So bringing one leg up to tabletop and back down. Always moving from the hip and keeping your knee at 90 degrees. Keep the pelvic floor onto floor three and focus on keeping that nice neutral pelvis position. And it really is not as easy as it might look. If you're quite experienced, and if you've been in this maybe for a few weeks, you might want to move on to something a little bit harder. So when you're ready, pelvic floor, pelvis in neutral, one leg at a time, come up into your tabletop position. Keep your hands to give you that feedback initially, and then see if you can take your arms away and find that stability once again. Neutral pelvis, pelvic floor onto floor three. And then the ultimate challenge is to see if you can move your arms. So I'm just going to do the hundreds exercise to see if I can pat the imaginary puddles of water by my side and still keep balanced on the roller. I definitely am not going to succeed in doing 100, but if I can do maybe 20 or so, I'll be pretty pleased. Okay, then one at a time, feet back down. And I think for a quick session on your rollers on the floor, that's a really, really good one to do. Okay, carefully extricate yourselves from the rollers. And you're going to start off in standing just on one roller. And get yourselves balanced first of all. Just find a nice neutral balance point and soften through your knees. And once you're happy that you're soft through your knees, make sure that you're relaxed through your neck and shoulders. I think this is one of the most beneficial aspects of working on rollers. For a lot of us, we hold tension around our neck and shoulders, and when we're riding, then that transmits into tension going down through the reins. And particularly, that's a problem if you're going to start schooling, if you're about to go into the competition arena. So if you can practice sort of recreating that when you're working on the roller and then working on relaxing through your upper body whilst you're working through your lower body, it's a really helpful situation because you're then prepared for when you go into the ring and the same thing starts to happen to you. So get yourself really balanced and then see if you can do a few squats, keeping your balance on the roller. And keeping soft and relaxed through your neck. Okay, once you feel that you can manage some of those, and it may be that's all you want to work on today, and that's absolutely fine, I would suggest you get good at that before you move on to anything else. You can then have a go at working on your upper body, and actually you'll probably be surprised at how easy this is in comparison. So soften through the knees. Oops. Pop your hands into your dumb waiter position. Draw your shoulder blades back and down. And then see if you can start to work your upper body. So arms out and back in, keeping your shoulder blades really nice and soft, back and down. And then see if you can turn it into the Cleopatra. So take your arms then out to the side and back in. Keeping nicely balanced on your roller. Keep soft and relaxed through your neck and shoulders. And if you can work your pelvic floor at the same time onto floor three, then you are doing really, really well. Okay, you can also in this position, practicing something like giving and retaking the reins or going into a jumping position. So you can try and have a go at doing some of these as well, if you feel competent and safe to do so. Okay, one more to do with just the one roller. And that is some rotations. I'm just falling off my mat, so I'm gonna go onto the grass. So soften through your knees, arms across your chest, head lights forwards, and then turn your shoulders from side to side. Just like you would standing, doing your warm up, keeping your shoulders level and your headlights facing the front. What you may well find is that when you start to add in a little bit more body movement, that actually you find it easier to keep your balance. So don't be afraid of giving yourself some challenges to do on your roller once you feel that you are competent with what you can already do. Okay, right, we're now going to add in two rollers. I'm going to get rid of my mat. And I'd like you to see if you can try and do some lunges on your rollers. So you want to feel like you're going forwards onto the front roller rather than just doing a squat on the two. So you're actually taking your weight forwards and back. So you're rolling both of your rollers forwards and backwards. Try to keep your headlights moving forwards as you go. And then swap over and have a go with your legs the other way around. Get your balance first of all, and then again forwards onto the front leg rather than just up and down on the two. Keep the headlights guiding the movement forwards and backwards. Keep checking that your neck and shoulders are relaxed. And then pick yourselves off your rollers. And I think it's always a good idea when you finally get off your rollers to just make sure you almost did a little walking on the spot, because you can get quite a lot of very intense muscle contraction and that can actually make you quite uncomfortable. So have a little loosen off on the spot before you finally finish. So that's a summary of the basic foam roller exercises that I incorporate into my sessions. I think, like I said before, it's a fantastic piece of equipment. I don't expect anyone to work through all of those exercises straight away, but if you can build even some of those into your routine exercise regime, then you're really going to help yourself and your balance an awful lot. So thank you for joining me for that session. If you want any more information on the foam rollers, please check out the Ready to Ride blog, because there are more pictures to break down some of the exercises and a bit more background information. And I hope to see you again very soon.